From the highest peak in the world to the deepest point in the ocean, our planet is home to countless natural marvels. But have you ever wondered what lies beneath all this stunning scenery? Imagine our planet as an enormous cosmic onion, the layered structure of the onion similar to that of our planet.
In this video, we'll peel back the layers one by one and explore the secrets of each layer. And if you stay until the end, I will reveal which is the deepest point that has ever been reached by humans.
Get ready to travel thousands of kilometers beneath the surface, diving all the way to the heart of the planet, a region so dense it would crush you in seconds.
Are you ready for a journey that will forever change the way you look at the ground you stand on? Hello, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, I'm Maria, and I'm a scientist and a geology enthusiast, having fun exploring and sharing with you the many wonders of our planet. Today, we're embarking on an epic journey straight to the heart of our planet, exploring each of its layers. And yes, before we start, Earth is round. Well, not a perfect sphere, more like a squished basketball. It is definitely, definitely not flat. So do not worry, we won't fall off the edges of our planet as we explore its structure. Now, let's start exploring our planet's layers.
Earth has several layers with distinct physical and chemical characteristics. They have different compositions, dimensions, temperatures, and pressures.
Let's start by having a look at these layers and see which are the main layers of our planet. Based on the different characteristics of each layer, there are two ways of dividing the layers, chemically and mechanically.
Based on the chemical composition of the layers, we have the crust as the outmost layer. Beneath the crust, we have the mantle, which can be further subdivided into the upper mantle and the lower mantle. Further down, below the mantle, is the planet's core. When it comes to the mechanical classification of Earth's layers, moving from outside in, we start with the lithosphere, which includes the crust and the uppermost part of the upper mantle. Below the lithosphere sits the asthenosphere, which is part of the upper mantle, followed by the mesosphere, which comprises the lower mantle. Moving deeper inside the Earth, we have the outer core, followed by the innermost part of the planet, which is the inner core.
Now that we know what the different layers are and where they are located, let's have a closer look at each layer and learn what lies beneath our feet.
And we'll start with just that, what lies directly beneath our feet, the Earth's crust, our home base. The crust extends to a depth of 100 kilometers, that's about 60 miles below the Earth's surface. It is the thinnest of all layers, and its thickness varies depending on its location on Earth. Thus, under the oceans is where we find the thinnest crust, and this is called oceanic crust. It is only about 5 to 10 kilometers thick, that's around 3 to 6 miles. The thicker crust is found under the continents, where its thickness can vary between 30 and 70 kilometers, or 19 to 44 miles. This crust is called continental crust. The crust temperature varies from air temperature at the surface to about 870 degrees Celsius or 1600 degrees Fahrenheit in the deeper areas of the crust. The chemical composition of the Earth's crust depends on the crust type. Thus, the oceanic crust, while thinner, it is denser than the continental crust, and it consists of basalt rocks with silicon and magnesium being the most abundant elements. The continental crust is thicker, but less dense than the oceanic crust, and it is mainly formed of granite rocks with oxygen and silicon as the most abundant elements.
Earth's crust is divided into sections known as tectonic plates. My next video is dedicated entirely to plate tectonics. But for now, I will just mention that tectonic plates are in constant motion beneath us.
They are moving, but they are moving very slowly, only about 3 to 5 centimeters or 1.2 to 2 inches per year. Despite this continuous movement, we usually don't notice them unless an earthquake occurs. This is because the plates rest on the Earth's mantle, more specifically the asthenosphere, which allows them to float and shift. Occasionally, this gradual movement, known as plate tectonics, triggers earthquakes and volcanic eruptions.
We'll talk more about volcanoes and volcanic eruptions in a future video. Now, let's have a closer look at the mantle and see why the tectonic plates are able to float above it.
The mantle is located between 100 kilometers and 2,900 kilometers, that's between about 60 and 1,800 miles below the Earth's surface. This makes the mantle the thickest layer of our planet. The outermost layer of the mantle is cooler and more rigid, behaving similarly to the crust above it. That's why we can cluster these two into the mechanical layer called the lithosphere. The deeper we go in the mantle, the hotter it gets, and it can get as hot as 4,000 degrees Celsius as we get near the core. Besides being hotter than the crust, the mantle also has a higher pressure than the crust.
And you know what forms under pressure? Diamonds! That's right, the mantle is where diamonds are formed. If you want to learn more about diamonds and how they are formed and how they get from the upper mantle all the way to the Earth's crust, then I have this other video dedicated entirely to diamonds. And the second video if you want to learn about the many colors of diamonds.
Getting back to the pressures in the mantle, the deeper we go, the higher the pressure, reaching 135 gigapascals or 1.3 million atmospheres closer to the core. The mantle is a layer of hot, dense rock rich in iron, magnesium, and silicon. Although it's solid, it behaves like a thick semi-solid material due to the immense heat and pressure conditions we now know are present in the mantle. The mantle is much denser and thicker than the crust, allowing the tectonic plates above it to float and shift, occasionally leading to earthquakes. The layer of the mantle that flows and moves the plates is called the asthenosphere and sits right below the rigid lithosphere. The rest of the mantle that's below the asthenosphere is called the mesosphere, and it is more rigid than the asthenosphere.
Before moving to the next layer, if you're enjoying this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more videos about the many wonders of our planet.
Now let's talk about our planet's core. It is divided into the outer core, right below the mantle, expanding between 2,900 and 5,100 kilometers, or roughly 1,800 to 3,200 miles, and the inner core, located between the depths of 5,100 and 6,378 kilometers, or roughly 3,200 to 3,960 miles. Both the outer core and the inner core have similar compositions, being composed mainly of iron and nickel. However, despite their similar composition, these two layers are very different because of the different pressure and temperature conditions in these layers. The outer core has a much higher density and temperature than the mantle. The temperatures here vary between 4,030 degrees Celsius or 7,280 degrees Fahrenheit closer to the mantle to 5,730 degrees Celsius or 10,340 degrees Fahrenheit closer to the inner core. The pressure in the outer core ranges between 135 to 330 gigapascals, that's about 1.3 to 3.3 million atmospheres. While these are huge pressures, they're still lower than the pressure in the inner core, which is between 330 and 360 gigapascals, or 3.3 to 3.6 million atmospheres. And it's these high pressures that keep the inner core solid, while the material in the outer core is liquid. To be more precise, it's in a low viscosity fluid state.
This fluid layer undergoes turbulent convection, rotating faster than the rest of the planet, generating eddy currents in the molten metal. This creates a dynamo effect, which is believed to be the cause of Earth's magnetic field.
Recent studies indicate that the inner core also has a layered structure, with the possible existence of an inner core, possibly composed of iron in a different crystal form than that of the rest of the inner core.
But more research needs to be done to understand this better. Isn't it fun how new developments in science can help us learn more and more about our planet. And now, as promised in the beginning, let's see just how deep were humans able to reach.
The deepest hole humans have ever dug into the Earth is the Kola Super Deep Bore Hole in northwestern Russia, near the Russian border with Norway. This is the deepest man-made hole on Earth, and it reaches a depth of 12,262 meters or 40,230 feet. Considering the continental crust reaches a depth of 100 kilometers, this remarkable achievement shows us how much more of our planet remains unexplored.
If you enjoyed this video, then you might also enjoy this other video about magma, where I explain what magma is, how it is formed, the different types of magma, and I also clarify what is the difference between magma and lava. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!